Well, the Rays haven't gotten off to a great start this road trip. Series finale with the Twins in Minnesota, and they were in danger of something that hasn't happened in almost a decade, getting swept by the Twins, who last swept the Rays back in 2006. Chris Archer on the bump for the Rays, his first road start since April 16th, hasn't lost a game on the road in over a year. Arch gives up the first run of the game in the bottom of the first. Joe Mauer up the middle scores Brian Dozier. 1-0 Twins, top of the third inning now. Evan Longoria with bases juiced finds the hole in left. Bobby Wilson going to cross the plate to tie things up. Next batter, James Loney, grounds into the fielder's choice, but he gets the RBI. Kevin Kiermaier scores from third base. Rays lead 2-1. Skip ahead to the sixth. Longoria with the base hit up the middle. That brings in two. Rays ahead 6-1 at that point. But they continue pounding the Rays. The Twins, 19 hits on the day. They avoid the sweep 11-3. The final. After the game, Longoria said that the 19-hit performance shows off what the Rays are capable of offensively.
Yeah, I mean, you know, of course not every night. Today's always an anomaly, no matter what team you are. I mean, and 19 hits is a lot of hits, but I definitely think we're capable offensively of doing good things, and today was it was pretty evident.
And next up for the Rays, an interleague series with the Braves in Atlanta today. Braves ace Shelby Miller goes 9 innings without allowing a hit against the Marlins. Watch it here. He actually loses it with 2 outs in the ninth. Justin Gore breaks up the no-no. Braves won it 6-0. And more bad news for the Marlins. They dismissed manager Mike Redmond after the game. The Rays are off tomorrow before their two-game set with the Braves starting on Tuesday. Down 1-0 in their series with the Rangers, but will they be down a starter again in Game 2? Forward Brian Boyle did not play in Game 1 with an undisclosed injury. Today he did not practice, and Coach John Cooper said Boyle is still considered day-to-day. The rest of the Bolts were back at Madison Square Garden practicing this afternoon. Rangers beat the Lightning 2-1 yesterday to take Game 1 of the series. Game 2 is tomorrow night at 8 o'clock. Andre Palat scored the Bolts' lone goal of the game. And at this point, everybody's got to be ready to put the puck in net. Coach Cooper agrees. He said the Bolts can't rely on just the triplets to score goals.
If we want to advance, we're going to need more than the triplets to score. And when you've looked at some of these big games, we've had other guys score. We've had other guys contribute. Look across the hall, and they're... I mean, they haven't scored a ton of goals in the playoffs, but they're getting a balanced attack from a lot of guys. And it's not, you know, the Rick Nashes that have scored every single night. They've had guys chip in, and they're advancing, and that's how we're going to have to do it, is we need more guys to chip in.
The stars were shining up in Charlotte for the Sprint Cup All-Star race last night. A huge prize was on the line. How does $1 million sound to you? The All-Star race was split up into 5 segments. The last one was a 10-lap shootout. Denny Hamlin led every lap after the restart. He held off Kevin Harvick in the end to take the checkered flag at Charlotte Motor Speedway. It was Hamlin's first win in the All-Star race, but it was also Joe Gibbs' first All-Star win and Toyota's first as well. Hamlin won the $1 million bonus. Here he is in victory lane.
We all get nervous talking about that.
You want to win the Daytona 500, you want to win the Brickyard 400, you want to win the Coke 600, and you want to be an All-Star. So, can't say enough for this whole FedEx Express team. Everyone from Toyota getting their first All-Star victory as well. It's just an unbelievable experience. We just didn't have a car that was fast enough to run with those guys until Dave made that last adjustment, and of course clean air. But I mean, that pit crew, that's all I could say. They carried me all day long, and they got us this victory.
Congratulations, Denny Hamlin. On the track today, the Xfinity Series took over Iowa Speedway. Off the green white checkered restart, check it out, Chris Buescher fast off the restart goes low on Chase Elliott, the reigning Xfinity Series champ, and that would seal it for Buescher. He cruises to take the checkered flag at Iowa. It's his first win of the season and second of his career. And another scary scene at Indianapolis Motor Speedway. Ed Carpenter, the latest to crash into the wall during practice for next weekend's Indy 500. Carpenter's car went airborne, hit the wall, and flipped. Thankfully, he was uninjured after the fiery crash. Carpenter was checked into and released from the infield medical center shortly after the wreck. He is the third driver whose car has crashed during practice in the last week. After this latest crash, IndyCar announced changes to reduce speeds to avoid another scary scene just like that. Wow. Luckily, all three of those drivers walked away okay after those scary wrecks.
That's amazing.
It sure is. What a sight.
Yeah.
Marissa, thank you very much.